Hello, I'm Toygun Başaklar. And today I'm gonna talk about short tau inversion recovery. So in some clinical diagnosis, removing fat contribution to the MR signal without affecting the tissue of interest is significant. And fat suppression techniques can be used to improve tissue contrast and lesion conspicuity, and to observe that if the tissue of interest has high or low lipid level, and to remove some artifacts. So they are used mainly for better differing the tissue of interest from the fat signal. With suppressing fat signals, some diseases and abnormalities can be easily diagnosed. There are several fat suppression techniques. Each has its own advantages and disadvantages. But in today, I'm gonna talk about short tau inversion recovery. So my outline is like that. First, I'm gonna talk about what is inversion recovery, and then I'll explain what is short tau inversion recovery, what does this short tau refer to, and this inversion time to null points, and properties of resulting images, and its advantages, array of use, and image examples, also disadvantages of that method. So inversion recovery. Conventional spin echo sequence preceded by 180 degree inverting pulse is called inversion recovery. The sequence starts with a 180 degree RF pulse, which flips longitudinal magnetization MZ of all tissues in the opposite to the direction of the main magnetic field, minus MZ. Due to longitudinal relaxation, the inverted tissues are tend to reestablish their longitudinal magnetization to their initial value, of course bypassing through the null value. Then, to measure the signal, a 90 degree RF pulse, excitation pulse, is applied to obtain transverse magnetization. The time between the first 180 degree inversion pulse and the 90 degree excitation pulse is called inversion time, TI. So, when spin echo signal generation begins at the 90 degree inversion excitation pulse, the initial longitudinal magnetizations of different type of tissues are now separated based on their different T1 relaxation times. The gathered image contrasts will be determined by this degree of separation, which is controlled by the TI parameter. So, an inversion recovery sequences provide image with high T1 contrast and can be expressed as this equation. Also, if TI is chosen such that longitudinal magnetization of a tissue is null, then the spins of this tissue cannot have any effect on the obtained MR signal due to the absence of transverse magnetization, which is also due to the absence of longitudinal magnetization. Hence, the inversion recovery technique allows the suppression of signal of a tissue by selecting the TI according to the T1 of this tissue. Additional contrast effects are also obtained by varying of TR and TE. So, what is STIR? Short tau inversion recovery. STIR is a fat suppression technique in which the inversion time TI sequence is chosen such that the fat signals are suppressed, does not contribute to resulting image. So, at 1.5 Tesla, T1 fat is equals to 260 milliseconds, and generally other tissues T1 is greater than 500 milliseconds. So the amount of time to reach the null point where there is an absence of longitudinal magnetization for the fat signal is smaller than other tissues. Therefore, at this null point, if the standard MRI sequence, in this case spin echo or fast spin echo, is started, then the fat signals will not contribute to the resulting image while the other tissues will contribute. So how does we select this TI to null point? TI null depends on the ratio of TR over T1 and also if the sequence is fast spin echo or conventional spin echo, and can be derived as follows. It also affected by the field strength since T1 increases as the field strength increases. So if TR is much larger than T1, then TI null equals to T1 tissue multiplied by ln2, and TI null for the fat tissue is 180 milliseconds at 1.5 Tesla in this case. But in practice, other sequence parameters like TR also affects this TI null. So generally, yani null is less than this calculated value. So how is the properties of the resulting image if we use str? So the resulting image is considered as T1 weighted image. Unfortunately, the contrast will be inverted relative to a conventional T1 weighted image. Tissues with short T1 will appear darker, while tissues with long T1 will appear brighter. Also, the resulting signals will be smaller in magnitude because of the relaxing during TI periods. Generally, T1 fat is much shorter than the T1 of other tissues, but in a case when T1 fat nearly equals the T1 tissue, then this tissue will also be suppressed if STR is used. So let's have a look at advantages and the array of use of STR. The STR is desirable among other fat saturation techniques, especially near metallic foreign bodies, near tissue interfaces with high susceptibility, and across large body parts. For bone metastasis, it can be possible to perform a whole body STR imaging. STR sequences provide excellent depiction of bone marrow edema, which may be the only indication of an occult fracture. It is also used for suppression of the marrow signal from around joints in vertebrae and the suppression of the fat signal in the orbits to better differentiate tissues of interest like cartilage and ligaments, bone metastasis, optic nerve, etc. In conventional T1 weighted spinecho imaging, tissues with a long T1 and T2 have destructive effects on signal, but in STR imaging, the effects of T1 and T2 are constructive. This results from the fact that longitudinal magnetization of long T1 tissues on STR remain inverted and produces a high signal. Also, STR is insensitive to magnetic field inhomogeneities. So here are some image examples. In this figure, we can see the additive T1 and T2 effects. The left one is obtained with conventional T1 weighted. Is an image of conventional T1 weighted image, and you can see there is an MS plaque clearly seen in the STR image on the right one. And this one shows an STR image with an excellent fat suppression, allowing optic neuritis to be well seen. As you can see the white area. In this example, it's a T1 MRI of osteochondritis dissecans, T1 weighted image from the left side, and it is the same area with STR imaging, with the fat suppressed, of course, and we can clearly see the bone edema here with white, brighter. This image is the comparison of fast spinecho and STR sequences for depiction of bone marrow, both showing pancarpal rheumatoid arthritis. So the left one is T1 weighted fast spinecho image and the right one is STR image. So the extent of bone marrow edema throughout the carpal bones, distal radius and ulna is better depicted in STR images. You can see the edges of this the bone edema is clearly seen with STR. Here is an example of comparison of magnetic field inhomogeneities with fast spinecho versus STR sequences. So the left image is the sagittal T2 weighted fast spinecho image obtained with spectral fat suppression, which requires a uniform magnetic field and shows incomplete fat saturation in regions where there is a field inhomogeneity, such as irregular air soft tissue interfaces of the toes, here pointed with an arrow. And on the right, sagittal image obtained with STR, which is less susceptible than fast spinecho sequences to magnetic field inhomogeneities, provides more uniform and more complete fat saturation, as you can see. So here, the left one is an STR image shows an insufficiency fracture of the distal tibia with an extensive array of high signal intensity in bone marrow. You can see brighter area. The right one is an interesting one. This is the whole body MRI using STR sequences. The figure A, subject A, shows an image of a normal subject, and B shows an image of a patient with neurofibromatosis 1 who has multiple lesions in his or her body. So most pathological tissues have high proton density and long T1 relaxation and T2 decay. So STR images show lesions as regions of high signal intensity, as it can be seen from the figure. These are all the lesions, the bright ones. So the main disadvantage of STR is that it needs long excision time, since TR must be longer than conventional T1 weighted ones to give the spins enough time to recover. Fast spin echo is used for a solution to that problem and reduce this time to a reasonable amount. Also, STR is sensitive to spatial non-uniformity of the applied RF pulse. For example, if the strength of the RF pulse changes according to the position, then the tip angle of the inversion pulse also changes according to the position, which causes a change in quality of the fast separation. Also, SNR can be reduced, although CNR for certain tissues may be improved. An extra energy will be built up by multiple 180 degree pulses, and therefore the heat in tissue may be increased. So these are my references. Thank you for listening.